You thought you were so smart. You thought you knew where lightning came from, but you don't, because it comes from the sun. Howdy, light bulbs. Trace here, coming at you from D News with your weekly space update. Lightning is a fairly common way for nature to showcase its raw power. Molecules in the clouds bump and grind up on each other, creating a buildup of static electricity. As the cloud becomes charged up with electricity, electrons snake up from the ground as well to make a circuit. That's called the step leaders. When the electrons meet, lightning. Science is awesome. That's what we used to think. It turns out there's actually a bigger, badder baller on the block, the friggin' sun. A new study in Environmental Research Letters found that the solar wind may be affecting the amount of lightning that we are seeing on the ground. The sun is constantly producing a stream of electrons and protons traveling a million miles an hour, flowing in all directions away from it. This is commonly called the solar wind, because the Earth is bathed in those high energy particles constantly, and during periods of high solar activity, like now, the solar wind blows even stronger. Though we think the sun is a solid ball, it's actually a giant nuclear furnace made of gas that takes 27 days to fully rotate. The particles it emits are therefore fluctuating in a predictable pattern as well. The scientists describe the solar wind as waves because it can vary in density, temperature, and charge based on where the sun is in its monthly cycle. When these high energy particles hit Earth's magnetic field, we get aurora. We've talked about that before, and they usually just kind of bounce off and keep going. However, when a relatively slow solar wind wave is overtaken by a relatively fast wave, it overwhelms Earth's magnetic field, and some of those particles actually break into the upper atmosphere, charging up the clouds and causing an increase in either the frequency or intensity of lightning. The scientists weren't exactly clear on which it was, whether it was a rate of lightning or intensity. You'd think you'd want to be more clear on that. It's not just our sun causing the static buildup either. When other stars explode, millions of light years away, they also send out these high energy particles, and some of them do eventually hit us as well. Mathematically, this is like mind-boggling, right? What are the chances of a star exploding millions of years ago at just the right time to shoot out a particle which after millions of years will hit us and cause a lightning strike that will finally give me superpowers? What are the chances? Knowing this, the scientists say, may help improve long-term weather forecasting, somehow. Knowing the sun cycle and solar wind and all that. Are you blown away by this solar wind thing? Tell us in the comments below, and you know what? Get funky with it. Make sure you subscribe, and also, space friends, next Wednesday, we are doing a Google Hangout with NASA JPL, and it's gonna rock, literally, because we're talking about meteors. Check the description for the link to RSVP and get your questions ready. I am super excited about this, to say the least. It's gonna be every month, oh my God! Subscribe for more videos every day of the week and come say hey to us on Twitter at DNews or me at Trace Dominguez. And thanks for watching. Y'all are the bestest.